Today we're going to make the claw mechanism that was shown on the Yale website. What you'll need for this is a servo. You'll need some servo gear adapters, the claw mechanism. We're going to use a 120 degree bracket angle, a servo programmer, two wheels, screws, nylon nucks, and zip ties. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to work on the servo and making sure the servo is in the right position, and then we'll walk through the assembly. All right. The next step we're going to do is make our claw mechanisms. What's cool about these is what we're going to do is we're going to use a technique without using screws, and what you'll see is we'll use zip ties. What's really important is that zip ties have a natural way where when you actually put them in, and I'm not using zip ties from the first global kit, I'm just using regular zip ties. When they go in, you should hear them ratchet. So I'm going to assemble this, and then I'll make the video of the assembly at the end, all right? So basic idea is we're going to sandwich two of these in between the white gripper, and we'll show you that, and then we'll put wheels at the end. So here's an example of one of the arms. You can see I've sandwiched the two, I've sandwiched the arm between the two brackets. And the wheel, and make sure that the zip tie is on the back side of the wheel, not on the front, because that's where the gripper will kind of move in. And now I'll finish the second one off. And there are the two arms, and you can just cut these things, the ends of the zip ties off with wire clips or scissors. All right, so next we're going to do is we're going to actually take the servo, and we're going to put the servo gear adapter onto the servo. So if you look at the servo up close, there's what's called the spline, and it's little teeth on the end of the servo hub. Inside these gears, servo gear adapters, one side is smooth, and on the inside of the other is little teeth, which you'll see, it's hard to see in the video, but the teeth side should fit right onto there. And it's going to be hard, so you're going to have to press it on really good. I'm going to pause the video and put it on so you can see. So you should see that the servo gear is on the servo pretty nicely. It should not be extra. What we're going to do next is we're going to get the servo ready to be mounted into the gripper assembly. So I've put the 8mm screw hex heads on the claw assembly. I put the head on the inside side where there's these flat nubs, and the nuts on the pattern side, or the one which is indented. The way it's going to work is we're now going to assemble the motor. The servo. And the way the servo will fit in is we'll fit in through the hole like this. And so the next step will be to put the servo through. So what you're going to do to get the servo in is we're going to put the hex heads, you're going to put the hex heads through on this side, and then you will tighten the nuts on the other side. All right. And I'll show you that in the next shot. Okay. So we've now attached the servo to the claw mechanism with these four screws. The hex heads are on the top, the nuts are on the back, but don't tighten them. You want them to be loose. If you notice that there's space between the servo and the top, we're going to try and move the servo all the way to the top, and we're going to tighten it so that it is closest to the top of the claw mechanism, so that you should see very little space up here. So let me tighten those four screws, and then what we're going to do is we're going to need to learn how to program the servo. So now that the screws are tightened, we're going to need to start putting the assembly together. So this is your servo programmer. If you notice, there's a port on the top. The servo plugs into there. The way it plugs in is that there is a white wire, and that white wire goes into what's called S. That's the signal. So we're going to plug that in. There's a switch here that goes into C or S. And we're going to leave the switch on to S. So the next thing is we're going to turn on the servo. What you see is the gear starts moving, right? And it's going from one position to the other. So in this mode, it kind of goes from an open position to a closed position. Now to program it, I'm going to hit the program button. I'm going to hit test one more time, not the program button. And now you see the program light on and the test light on. The servo gear is now in the center position. Now, with the servo gear in the center position, I'm now going to attach my two arms. And what's important is those two arms, because this is the center of the motion, what I'm going to do is I'm going to make it so that they are lined up so that the center lines mesh as best as they can. Do you see these two lines on the... Let me just get this one second. Put the one in. Maybe easier to put the one in with the servo. And you can see that two lines over there are meshed, right? Now I'm going to take the second part of the assembly and I'm going to put it on. And finally, we're going to screw the... We're going to put the... While holding this down together with my one hand, I'm going to start putting the rev bar in. So I'll come back in a second with the rev bar in. So you may need to play around with this and get that in to position, but actually it's right there. You don't want the rev bar to hit the gear, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to tighten the three screws that I have for the rev bar on each side. So I first go one side, I'll tighten the other side, and make sure the nuts are all in. And so I'll tighten all of them. One, two, three. And one, two, three. Okay, why don't we pause? Now we're going to actually program the arm to be able to the right grip positions. If you noticed, the test was flashing with the program. When I hit test again, all the lights go out. But for now, what you can see is when I hit test, it goes to the two positions, but the positions aren't gripping. So I'm going to hit test one more time, and you can see I'm back into the program mode in the middle. Now I'm going to hit test again. All the lights go out. What I'm going to do is I'm going to adjust the gears, make sure they don't adjust the arms, make sure they don't slip, and move them to the point where they're actually gripping the block. Now, I may go a little bit beyond that, maybe make it a little bit smaller. And now I'm going to push the right button. And when the right button comes on, that means it's programmed that position. So now I'm going to actually open it up, and I'm going to hit the left position. Now, if the lights don't go on, that means it's an invalid position. You may want to try right with left and left with right. When I'm done with those two positions, I hit program. And you can see now it's been programmed. Now, if I hit test, what you should see is it should go to the new position where it is gripping the block. Now, if I go to, if I keep this position, I can hit left. When test is flashing, I can hit left, it goes to open. If I hit right, it goes to the closed position, and I'm gripping the block. Okay? And now you can actually program that servo gripper, and we can talk about how you might put this gripper on something else. How to program the servo, you can actually use this programmer to also test things. When the test is flashing, it's just automatically going between the two positions. If I hit test again, it's in a test mode where the center light comes on, it's in its center position. If I hit the left button, it goes into the left position. And if I hit the right button, it goes into the right position. So this is a good way to test out whether your gripper works. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open it. And what I'm going to show you is what we see is that the gripper can easily grip the block. So if I go to the right position, what you'll see is it picks up it can grip the block. And you can sort of see that it picks it up. Now, if I hit the left button, it opens up and drops it. What's neat about this gripper as it was designed, was you could actually put it on and see if you can pick up the solar panel. So I'm going to flip it around for a second. So when it comes down, you might put this on an arm, put it down. I'm going to hit the right button. It kind of grips it. And there you have it. We've got actually a gripper picking up the solar panel. Hit the left, and it drops it. All right. Hopefully this helps. Thanks.